Hello there, my RPG lovers, and welcome to another video. At first glance, Biomutant might seem like a game that's meant for your annoying little cousin, but underneath that fluffy characters and vibrant colors, there's a full-blown RPG game that seems to bring a lot of interesting and unique mechanics to this genre. Devil May Cry plus Ratchet & Clank. That's probably the most accurate way of describing my initial impressions of this game. The mutations and the ability to change your genetic structure, which will affect the way you look and play, are probably the two most interesting things about this game. While making your character, or biomutant to be more precise, your physical traits will directly affect your stats. For example, if you have a big head, that doesn't mean that you're smart, you're probably only fat. Okay, back to the game. If you give your mutant a big head, he will gain more intellect. Or if you make him skinnier, you'll gain agility and so on. You get the picture, fatty. It's also good to know that later in the game you will be able to change your genetic structure again. There is also leveling and you can spend your level up points to upgrade these stats, so yeah, like I said, a full-blown RPG. What's even more interesting are physical mutations. While exploring the world, you can find these green pools where you can unlock your physical mutations such as mantis claws, barbed tails, mutated shoulders that reflects bullets to your enemies, etc. But in order to unlock these mutations, you will need to have bio points that you can get by defeating certain monsters called Morks, I believe. It goes without saying that these monsters will not be easy to kill and they will also be able to infect you somehow. Apart from those green pools, you can also find radioactive machines in bunkers beneath the world, which will allow you to unlock psionic mutations. These mutations are described as X-Men mutations, which will probably require higher intellect. Really interesting concept, and I'm really eager to learn these mechanics in depth. The martial arts style combat, where you can mix shooting, melee, and powers from your mutations, looks really satisfying and responsive. The animations look really good and everything just flows great. Like I said, it reminds me of Devil May Cry and most importantly, it looks fun as fuck. There's also this bar that needs to be filled and once you manage to do that, you can use your Wushu combat style. In one example, we could see one Wushu with guns, in another, the player uses this move with a melee weapon. We'll be able to acquire new Wushu combat styles from masters that we can find in the world or through progression. One more feature that was showcased in the video is the crafting system. Now this reminds me of Fallout 4 crafting system where you can mix and match different parts to make your unique weapon. There are different qualities of these parts and you can mix and match some crazy combinations if you have the right parts. Of course it goes without saying there are different kinds of ranged and melee weapons and besides crafting them yourself, you will be able to find characters that can craft this stuff for you. If I understand correctly, there is no ammo for ranged weapons, only cooldowns for using them. Don't quote me on that though, but I think that's how they work. Speaking about Fallout 4, we also have this thing like the power armor that we can upgrade with different parts. We'll be able to equip different gear and they mentioned items like gas masks, thermos resistant clothes for cryonic areas and protective gear for taking on biocontaminated creatures. But how about the world and the story, you may ask? Well, it's an open world game with 7 different biomes. According to developers, all of the zones have different terrains with unique creatures and enemies spread across the world. Speaking about the world, there is a weather system of course, but there is a dynamic seasonal system as well. For example, when it's cold, the water will freeze in some places, allowing you to explore some areas that were previously inaccessible. You will be able to explore on foot, on a mount, mechs, jet ski, air balloons, etc, etc. The story is about the end of the new world, whatever that means. A plague is ruining the land and the tree of life is bleeding dead from its roots. There are consequences for your actions, you can unite tribes or break them and ultimately you'll decide how the story of survival ends. The one and only thing that bothers me is the storyteller that narrates your every step, but it's good to know that we can turn him down almost completely. Like we can read here, fortunately THQ Nordic say that the amount of narrator interjects decreases over time, getting lower for every hour you play the game in single session. I feel like it would be really weird and annoying to hear this guy all the time, even though he's doing a great job with voice acting.
The tribes caught a fluffy hulk! Better watch out, it's no pet.
I need to brush up on my Wongo, but I think he says he's surprised the tribe got a sprocket off ground.
And that's all the information for now, pretty much. This game really has some interesting concepts that are not really explored that much in RPGs, and I hope it delivers. The only thing we know about the release date is that it's coming in 2019. Like you probably guessed by now, I will keep my eye on this game and I'll update you on every new piece of information, so be sure to subscribe. I have a lot of RPG stuff on this channel that you can check out, because that's all I'm about. If you want to support me even further, you can do that by becoming a Patreon or an exclusive YouTube member. All the links are in the description. See ya in the next one.